Why are you here?
Let me put it very simply, Vince. I'm taller than you. I'm better looking than you. I think I'm stronger than you.
Wow.
And I'm here to challenge you to a match in WrestleMania.
What?
Oh, I get it. It's the Battle of the Billionaire.
That's right.
Hey, wait a minute. I know you have an ego, but I had no idea it was that big, all right? I mean, come on. You want to challenge me to a match at WrestleMania?
Absolutely right. 100%. I will kick your ass.
Oh! The Battle of the Billionaire!
Listen, I think you know something that the rest of this audience does not know. In my last match in Hell in a Cell, I suffered a split pelvis and a broken coccyx, and my physician, it's true, my physician has suggested to me that I do not compete ever again inside the squared circle. So the answer is no.
A broken coccyx?
Oh. Wait a minute. I appreciate your proposal, but I think I have a counter proposal. Since I'm actually unable to physically compete, why don't I find a representative? Why don't I find a hand-picked competitor to represent me? You find someone to represent you, I'll be in my guy's corner, you'll be in his. What do you say? Put her there.
I don't like it. I don't like it. I really don't like it. I'll tell you what. You're a rich guy. I'm a richer guy. Here's what we'll do.
Not about enough of this.
Here's what we'll do. Here's what we'll do. You pick a representative. I'll pick a representative. I'd rather do it one-on-one with you, Vince.
I know where you're going. You're going to raise the stakes on me. I know that. Okay. Donald Trump wants to raise the stakes, all right? That means one thing, cash money, all right? I get that. Hey, whoa.
How much?
All right, I'll admit I can buy and sell each and every one of these individuals in this arena tonight. I admit you have more money than me. Go ahead.
You're right, he is scared. You're right. Let me tell you something, Vince. You deal in cash all the time. I deal in cash all the time. It comes a time where that gets a little boring. I have another idea. You pick a representative. I'll pick a representative. If you lose, I get to shave your head.
No! Shave his head? What?
If I lose, you get to shave my head. Now.
What?
Now. It's not going to happen, though. I damn well better win. But let me just go somewhere. I've heard for a long time that that's not your hair.
There it is. He paid for it.
You've heard for a long time that this isn't my hair. You see it? Look. Check it. You've heard it. Today I had a story in a big newspaper saying I was the greatest, Vince. But you know what? They said I wore a hairpiece. I
what?
Don't wear a hairpiece. Someday maybe, but not now. So Vince, our deal. You lose, you get your head shaved at WrestleMania. I lose, I get my head shaved at WrestleMania.
Oh my gosh. Is he kidding? What a stipulation, JR. The stakes couldn't get any higher.
All right. How many of you people want to see a hair match between McMahon and Trump?
Me, I do. Oh, yes.
Well, the answer is no. And I'll tell you why. No, really. I'm not going to be embarrassed by
no
this
guts.
Man again. He's got something up his sleeve, I know damn well. No.
Wow. I can't believe Mr. McMahon is backing away from this challenge. I'm a little surprised myself.
Jay, you know, Vince, I've known you a long time, and honestly, until now, I always thought you had guts. You don't have guts. I saw 3 weeks ago you put on a match, and the match was Donald Trump against this real dog named Rosie O'Donnell, a real dog. And I was angry at you because the wrestler that portrayed Rosie O'Donnell was too good looking, much better looking than Rosie is in life, all right?
I still think you've got something up your sleeve, Mr. Trump, but you know what? The match is on!
The match is on!
See you in Detroit, man.